Last November 10, Bungie released a new expansion for Destiny 2 called Beyond Light, and with it, introduced a new subclass, Stasis. Stasis is a completely unique subclass in Destiny 2 compared to the others, and with Destiny 2 being Destiny 2, it wasn't balanced. Now, since the release of the expansion, it's had its ups and downs and in-betweens, but mostly downs. But today, we're going to be talking about my three reasons why I absolutely hate the Stasis subclass in Destiny 2. If you guys like the video, give the video a thumbs up. I cover different topics about a variety of games, but recently I have been covering some RPG games because that's kind of like my niche right now. So if you want to get notified when I upload, click on the subscribe button. It would help me out a lot. Reason number one is that there is no counterplay when you get frozen. Pretty self-explanatory here. If you get frozen, you gon' die. No two ways about it unless your enemy somehow misses every shot that he makes or somehow decides you are not worth the kill. Doesn't matter if you're in cover or the enemy can't see you when you're frozen, because while you're frozen, you now have a tracker on you that shows your exact position. You could break free from this early, but that would take a huge amount of your health, and your character goes into like a 1 or 2 second animation of breaking free, which is just more than enough time for your enemy to pick up the kill. Absolutely no counterplay. This would have been okay if only the supers froze, but no. We have grenades that shoot tracking projectiles that climb through walls that insta-freezes you, and if they hit you, spawns more tracking projectiles to track the other guardians and so on and so forth. You can basically freeze an entire team with a single grenade. Now, if the abilities just slowed, that would at least give the affected a little bit of that chance to counterplay with a well-placed shot. Now, I also know that Kamikakes just made a video to help and try combat stasis. I just watched it a few days ago. It's a pretty good video. Go check it out. The things that he states there, I think, don't really apply to the average Destiny 2 player, because me personally, I don't have enough time to invest into Destiny 2 to become as good as them to be able to avoid getting frozen. And like, some of these tips are very basic, but to actually be able to like put in the muscle memory to do these things on a consistent basis is kind of not in my options as of now. Now on to reason number two, and that is stasis itself is unbalanced. Now the reason for this is because I think warlocks have it better off compared to titans, and actually even hunters have it better off than titans. Okay, so as I was typing this script, Bungie just released an update that nerfed a ton from the Warlock subclass, but that just solidifies my point that Warlocks are just better right now with the Stasis subclass. Warlocks have a ranged melee that will freeze on hit, and Hunters have this too, and while Hunters' melee doesn't actually freeze immediately with a single shuriken, they do have two charges of that, and those shurikens bounce off of walls and guardians and will also track. Titans though, they get a melee that while it's really superb for mobility and like the best mobility that Titan has ever seen in Destiny 2, it's just not on par with the other melee skills. It does not freeze and it does not one-shot. It does push away a lot, deals a lot of damage, but again, does not one-shot, does not freeze. Even if you bonk the enemy on the wall with the melee, he will not die. So I really think that Titans drew the shorter end of the stick on the melee abilities here. Now for the supers, I still think the same as well. Titans definitely way worse off than Hunters and Warlocks, especially the Warlocks. The Warlock super can throw off projectiles that will freeze you on hit, and the Shatter will insta-kill you. The range on the Shatter is just freaking near infinite, bro. You will not escape that. Now for Hunters, while it is just like a one-time, big-time throw, it does leave an AoE, a pretty large AoE that tracks enemies and moves pretty fast. If you are caught in that, you are most likely going to die. And again, this also freezes supers. Now, the Titan heavy attack, the Violent Super, does not track enemies, although it will freeze anybody in the vicinity that you slam on, and everybody who makes contact with the crystals will not track. It has limited range, and people can easily dodge it by jumping high enough. Your light attack is now a lethal form of your melee ability, but it will not freeze or one-shot another person while in super. Now, this is a very big disadvantage because the other Stasis supers can freeze you while you're in super. And in that small window of time while you are frozen, or if you're caught off guard and are frozen while you're in super, they have more than enough time to shatter and kill you. So I really do think the Titans again drew the shorter end of the stick, just subclass wise here. And now on to my final reason why I absolutely don't like Stasis right now in its current form in Destiny 2. There are no improvements to the other subclasses. Now, this one I think Bungie did intentionally. This is to make sure that people start using Stasis more than the other subclasses, but without buffs to the OG subclasses and with Stasis being able to freeze you while in super, I think you're giving yourself some sort of handicap if you're not using Stasis. Now, I'm not sure how they're gonna buff the OG subclasses. You know, balancing was never really a thing in Destiny 2 to begin with, so I get it, we just have to deal with it. But I wish they added something new, or, you know, buff the other subclasses a little bit, just so that we can have like a little bit of incentive to keep on using them. Now, all in all, I feel like Bungie is focusing a lot on Stasis, which is not inherently bad in the first place. I like that they're trying new stuff, they're innovating, they're trying to evolve the game, and that's it's required to keep the game alive, right? But until the PvP balancing issues and the lack of incentive to use past subclasses persist, I can never truly be okay with the Stasis subclass as of now. Now, I want to know what you guys think, though. I know that in PvE, Stasis is alright. I love the feel of Stasis in PvE. I have no complaints with that. But in PvP, that's really where it just shows all its flaws. But I want to know what you guys think. Do you guys agree with everything that I said in this video? Do you guys disagree? Or do you guys have something else that you want to say that I did not say in this video? If you guys do, put it down in the comment sections below. I would love to know what you guys think about the Stasis subclass in its current form. I know that they're going to be adding a lot of stuff to the Stasis subclass down the line in the next seasons and whatnot. But yeah, I just want to know what you guys think. Let's have a discussion about it. I love talking about the games that I play a lot, and Destiny 2 is definitely one of the games that I play a lot. So yeah, if you guys like the video again, please do like the video. Tell me how the video went. Do you like this style of video, you know, where I talk about something and then there's just like gameplay in the background and whatnot? Comment on the video. I would love your feedback. So yeah, and again, if you like the video, please do subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.